I even had on my previous video a request for, well, bringing part two. So here's part two. Here you see some aluminum parts for the bridge, and I also have some polypropylene parts. Thank you. there was a little bit of sawing, and I got myself a pick guard and a thrush rod cover. And the parts for the bridge so far, we have the middle part and the front part and the back. Today I'm gonna saw the metal parts for the Rickenbacker. So let's start sawing the metal parts. He just missed it. The last part. Okay, so this is it. Just have to sand some parts off, and we are having a nice bridge. Thank you. Okay, and now we're gonna sand the back part of the bridge, the front of it, and make it nice and smooth. Okay, and some smoother sandpaper. Okay. Process of sanding the bridge, and one half I already have done, and now it's time to this part. So let's go to the sander. Thank you. and here you have a view of the bridge with all of its parts. And coarse sanded. And through these holes the screws for the intonation will come. And now I have to make it shine. And I'm starting with the damper. Well, here I am sawing the sliding slits for the bridge part that's moving up and down for the intonation. And it's going rather well. Didn't break his saw yet. Emphasize on the edge. And changing back to the other side again. Well, after a lot of sawing and filing and sanding, I did get myself a bridge with the screws for the intonation. These I still have to make. It's the damper, so the intonation, and the back part with the four holes for setting the intonation, and on the back four screws for placing it on the body. And then I'm also working in some separate videos on the knobs of the guitar, and in a special bonus video I will show you how I made these knobs. They're still not sanded and worked on, so they're a little bit rough, but I will sand them all smooth and paint them and have some nice knobs.